No sooner had Peter gone than a big gray wolf came out of the forest. In a twinkling, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked, and in her excitement, jumped out of the pond. But no matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf.
He was getting nearer. Nearer!
Catching up with her!
And then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her.
And now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. The wolf walked around and around the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home, took a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall.
One of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall.
grabbing hold of the branch. Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with her wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at her from this side and that. The bird did worry the wolf, how he wanted to catch her. But the bird was cleverer, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope around his tail tighter.